Today we're in the Valle du Jou, which is the cradle of complicated watchmaking. It's sometimes said that two is better than one, and we are going to check exactly that for you here at Audemars Piguet. We have a close look at a super cool Royal Oak double balance wheel open worked. If you're wondering what the watch looks like, this is it.
So the story of that double balance wheel skeleton watch was a morning when there was a session between several employees, watchmakers, and people in charge of research and development. Through the entire meeting, I was looking at somebody's wrist. What kind of watch is that? He's wearing something I've never seen before. May I see your watch? And I saw in the guy's eyes that he was scared for a second. What are you actually wearing? He said, boss, actually we wanted to talk to you about it because we actually work on something together. I said, what do you mean by together? I'm the person in charge of product and I've got an entire product department. And I was not the one who was asking for anything. The product department was not asking for anything. And the marketing department was not asking for anything. So yes, we are a few guys here. We worked on an evolution of the skeleton watch and we thought that we could do this. Say, who's we? And then they came back with the answer, and the answer, there were 10 people wearing actually the watch that day in the factory. So my first reaction was obviously, really? And then I say, show me the watch. So I looked at the watch and say, okay, so that's obviously an evolution of the skeleton version that we had in the 39 millimeter case. Is that better in terms of chronometry? He said, it should. Is it better in the watchmaker's eyes in terms of aesthetic? By far. Does it work? Because that's always a question, because you could work on new ideas, but maybe it's not as reliable as the prior one. Is it sustainable? Can we make several of them? Yes. Can we make many of them? Or you're gonna say it's only one or two or three watches a year? Say, no, it's good. So basically you are just telling me right now that we should kill the old one and that should be the new one. In your own words of saying it, that was his answer. He says, yes, absolutely. So you're lucky on two grounds. First of all, I find the watch to be completely outstanding, and it's beyond. It's really the result is really, really great. And the second thing is, when I think about it, I was a bad student in school and I was always doing things that nobody was asking me to do. So somehow I found the respect to say, what if some of our guys found the best possible idea to make a watch better, so be it. So I'm gonna forget completely the compliance part of the whole thing, the money they spent without asking for anything, because at the end the result was absolutely outstanding. And the proof is that right after the introduction of that new watch in the market, even people who had the first version of the skeleton Royal Oak sold their first and bought the second one immediately. So it was when I knew that it would be definitely a success. In 1978, the exact same thing happened with the perpetual calendar. The perpetual calendar came from one day as a wristwatch on one of our watchmakers, and he brought this to the CEO at that time and said, boss, I think we've been working on something nice, we want to show it to you. Nobody was asking for it. It's on the watchmaker's brain that the whole thing was created. But what I know for a fact, we managed to sell hundreds and hundreds of perpetual calendars for the years to come, and today that's a big part of our history.
L'idée de ce double balancier est venue suite à des réunions de séances techniques que nous avons eues, et en ressortant d'une séance technique en particulier, dans laquelle nous avions parlé exclusivement des doubles spiraux et comment nous pourrions implémenter ces doubles spiraux sur des calibres courants de la marque, on s'aperçoit vite que ça peut vite devenir compliqué à mettre deux spiraux l'un sur l'autre en termes de réglage, en termes de ce qu'on appelle la mise en marche. L'idée de mettre un deuxième balancier sur ce même axe était finalement pour pouvoir récupérer ce deuxième spirale de l'autre côté du mouvement et donc pouvoir faire le réglage de part et d'autre de l'axe de ce double balancier. Le choix du calibre 3120 a été fait parce que c'est un calibre qui est très connu au sein de notre maison. C'était l'occasion également techniquement de démontrer la valeur ajoutée du double balancier par rapport au balancier simple. Et là, chronométriquement parlant, on a vu immédiatement les avantages. Les avantages techniques du double balancier sont multiples. Premier avantage, c'est que vu qu'on a deux balanciers à inertie variable, donc chacun étant équipé de 8 mass slots, ça nous permet de faire un réglage beaucoup plus fin sur l'avance et le retard de la montre. Deuxième avantage, c'est l'équilibrage des masses de part et d'autre de la ligne d'échappement. Puisqu'on a un balancier dessous, un balancier dessus, on comprend tout de suite qu'on équilibre. C'est comme en effet l'axe d'une voiture avec les deux roues de part et d'autre. Donc deux volants d'inertie qui oscillent de part et d'autre cette ligne de transmission. Ensuite, un gros avantage évidemment esthétique pour le client de pouvoir observer sa montre, le mouvement de cet organe oscillant de chaque côté de sa montre.